Hello all, I am Dr. Prabhas Sanjanbal. In today's class, we will discuss about the conversion from contextual grammar to pushdown automata. We have already discussed about the construction of pushdown automata contextual grammar in the previous classes or previous lectures. But in this class, we will convert the contextual grammar to pushdown automata. Okay? How to convert if contextual grammar is available? So how to construct a pushdown automata for the given contextual grammar? See here. The contextual grammar. See here. If the context here, there are two conditions generally. Here there are two conditions. If the contextual grammar is in GNA form, if the contextual grammar is in GNA form or without GNA form. If the contextual grammar is in GNA form, what is the rules? If the contextual grammar is not in GNA form, what are the rules? Means how to construct the pushdown automata. Generally, there are two conditions. If the contextual grammar is in GNA form, means Greek back normal form. GNA form means Greek back normal form. We have already discussed about the construction of GNA form and what is GNA form in the previous classes. Greek back normal form. Okay, so if the contextual grammar is in GNF form, what are the rules? If the contextual grammar is not in GNF form, means without GNF form or not in GNF form, so what is the rule? So GNA form, what is the meaning of GNA form? See, GNA form rules are, GNA form or Greek back normal form, the rules are S to A alpha, where A equals to terminal, here A belongs to terminal and alpha. Alpha is the combination of any variable. Alpha belongs to variable star, means alpha is the combination of any variable. Okay, this is called GNA form. See, now in this class particularly, we'll discuss about without GNA form. In this class, we'll discuss about without GNA form. And in the next class, we'll discuss about if the contextual grammar is in GNA form or Greek back normal form, what are the rules for to construct the pushdown automata. So in this class, we'll discuss about without GNA form. Okay. So if the grammar is not in GNF form, if the grammar is not in GNF form, means S to alpha. If the grammar is not in GNF form, means S to alpha, where alpha belongs to V plus T whole star, means any combination of variable and terminal. Variable means non-terminal, we can also call it. Okay. So if the grammar is in S to alpha form, so what are the rules? These are the rules to construct the PDA. Okay. So the first rule, see, del Q0 epsilon Z0. That Q0 means initial state of the pushdown automata. Epsilon means null symbol. Z0 means initial stack element. Okay, Q0 epsilon Z0 equals to Q1, means here it will change the state, means Q1 comma S Z0. Here S means what? S means starting symbol. Okay, here S means starting symbol, means when it will read, first pushdown automata will read the initial stack element, it will push the start symbol in the stack. It will push the start symbol in the stack and change the state like K1. Okay, what is the next rule? The next rule here, del Q1 epsilon S. When it will read any variable, means top of the stack is variable. Read variable, see here. Here it is the grammar S to alpha. S to alpha means here variable is S. When top of the stack is variable, it will always read the null symbol. When top of the stack is variable or initial stack element, it always read means pushdown automata will always read the null symbol. Okay, pushdown automata will read the null symbol. So what is the output? The output is Q1 alpha. See here, Q1 read epsilon and S. S means here this is the variable. This is the variable. So right side is Q1 and alpha. Right side is Q1 and alpha. Okay. The left side is the variable and right side is the means right part of the prediction. Left side, left part of the prediction. Okay. So next transition is del Q1 AA. Here A is the terminal. A belongs to T. Here A belongs to T means terminal. Then it will change the state it does not change the state, same state, Q1 and Q1, here epsilon. This operation is also called as pop operation. This operation is also called as push operation. Okay. If top of the stack is variable, it is called push operation. If top of the stack is terminal, here top of the stack is variable. So that's why it is called push operation. If the top of the stack is terminal, it is called pop operation. It is called pop operation. So here, the third rule here, del Q1 epsilon Z0 means at last, if stack contains some extra elements, means initial stack element, pushdown automata will pop. Pushdown automata will pop the initial stack element. So how to construct? See here. Now we'll explain. Now we'll see that these rules mean the construction of pushdown automata from the context programmer with the help of one example. We'll try to explain. We'll try to understand. Okay. So, but in this class, we'll discuss about if the context programmer is not in GNA form. Okay. So the first question. See. The first question, construct the pushdown automata for the following context-free grammar. See, this grammar, one grammar is given S to ASB class AB. See, this grammar is not in, first we have to check this grammar is in GNF form or not in GNF form. Check, see, this grammar is not in GNF form. It is not in GNF form. GNF form. So we'll use the first rule. So we'll use the first rule. First rule means this rule. Okay. We'll use this one. So what are the rules here? S to AS, B, AB. So how to construct the pushdown automata? Now we'll construct the pushdown automata. The first is del Q0 epsilon Z0. This one. Del Q0 epsilon Z0 is nothing but Q1 S Z0. Remember one thing, the first transition and the third transition is always same for all questions. It's always same for all questions. Okay. Just simply you can copy first and third rule. Okay. The second. Now if the grammar is in S to alpha form. If the grammar is in S to alpha, so del Q1 epsilon, this one is S and Q1 alpha is here. So we can write del Q1 epsilon, here variable is S. So it is nothing but Q1, but ASB. Here this is nothing but alpha, and this is nothing but alpha. So ASB, ASB. Third, del, here one more production is there. So del Q1 epsilon, this is the variable, S is nothing but Q1 AB. Okay, then fourth one. So now check how many terminals are there. So there are two terminals in this grammar, but A and B, A and B. So we can use the pop operation. We can write, we can use these rules. Q1 AA, Q1 epsilon. So here del Q1. Here now we'll first write for the first terminal. Q1 AA equal to Q1 epsilon. Now fifth one. Now similarly we can write for B del Q1 B equals to Q1 epsilon. Okay. So similarly we just copy the third rule. Sixth one, del Q1 epsilon Z0 Q1 epsilon. Okay. So this one is called as pushdown automata. Pushdown automata for the following grammar means context free grammar, or if the grammar, if the context free grammar is not in GNF form. So this is the given, this is the pushdown automata. So now we'll check means how, this pushdown automata means how to check this pushdown automata for a valid string. Means if the string is valid, now we'll take one valid string. Now we'll check one valid string for this pushdown automata. We'll take one valid string. Now we'll take, so how to get, so valid string, let it is AABP. Now we'll take a string. So how to get this? Now we'll check the string is valid or not. First, we'll generate from this S2 ASB. Then we can write S2AB, also use S2AB. So it is nothing but, it means this parse tree will give AABB. Okay. So this string is valid. Okay. Now we'll check this valid string is accepted by this given PDA or not. Now we'll check how to check. See here. Now my string is AABB. Here AABB. Initially, now this is my first stack. Initially the stack contains Z0. Initially the stack contains Z0. Z0 means initial element of the stack. Remember one thing, if top of the stack is variable, it will read null symbol. If top of the stack is variable, it will read, if top of the stack is variable, it will read null symbol. If top of the stack, if top of the stack is terminal, it will read, it will read the string, means symbol of the string. It will read symbol of the string. Okay, so see here. If the top of the stack is Z0, Z0 means it's just like variable. So see, top of the stack is Z0, here epsilon, so Q0 epsilon Z0, means Q1 S Z0. Now it will push S in the stack. Now it will push S in the, means S means starting symbol, S in the stack. Okay. Now we'll see. This is the my second stack. See here top of the stack is S. Here top of the stack is S. If top of the stack is S, S means variable. If top of the stack is variable, it will read the null symbol. Okay. Here top of the stack is variable is here. See. we can execute second and third means transition, because here top of the stack is S, here top of the stack is S. Top of the stack both are S, and it will read both top of the stack S means variable means it will read not null super. So we can use either second or third. We can use either second transition or third transition. Since this PDA is called as NPDA. This PDA is called as NPDA means non-deterministic post on automata. So for means one input, for one input, there may be multiple outputs. Let I am taking the second transition. Okay. The second transition is ASB. So S will be replaced by this ASB. So Z0, this is P, this is A, and this is A. BSA. So means S will be replaced by ASB. Okay. Next, here top of the stack is A. Now check top of the stack is A. Now we'll execute the fourth one, means fourth transition. Here top of the stack is A means it will read this A. A and A. See here Q1 AA means this is pop operation. This is called pop operation. Now it will pop A. So now we'll construct one more. Stack Z0 B. So now we'll check. Here now my top of the stack is BS. Okay. Now my top of the stack is S. S means variable. So either we can use second or third transition. Let I am using the third transition. Since top of the stack is variable, it will read the null symbol. Okay, Q1 epsilon S means Q1 AB. So it will read what? AB means AB is replaced by this S. Okay. So see here. This is the fourth stack. Initial content Z0, B, and B, this is A. Okay. So see, my top of the stack is A. Since my top of the stack is A, now we'll check top of the stack is A, and next symbol of the given string is what? A and A both are matched. So Q1 AA means it will execute fourth transition. So fourth transition means Q1 epsilon means pop. So it will pop A. Next, my top of the stack is B. So now I'm again constructing one more. Z0 B. So see here, if here top of the stack is B and the next symbol of the string is B. B and B both are matched. Since B and B both are matched, the Q1 now it will execute push down automata will execute the fifth transition. Fifth transition means B and B means pop. This one is called pop. So B and B, it will pop this one. So the next one, Z0, this is B, the sixth stack. Here top of the stack is B, and the next symbol of the string is B. B and B both are matched, so it will execute the fifth transition. BB means Q1 epsilon. BB both pop. Next. The seventh stack, see, here it contains Z0. Here top of the stack is Z0. It will read epsilon, so it will execute the sixth transition. Q1 epsilon means it will pop the initial stack element. So now my stack is empty. Since my stack is empty, so the given string is accepted by the given pushdown automata. Okay. So this pushdown automata is generally using empty stack mechanism. empty stack mechanism. Okay. So these are the process to execute a means valid string or invalid string using the given pushed on automata. And this is the process of means construction means conversion from means context free grammar to pushed on automata. Now we'll check one more example. S2 AAB A2 BB slash A B2 AB slash B. Okay. So this is one context free grammar. Now we'll check this grammar is in GNF form or not. Okay. See, this production means first production is not in GNF form. This one is GNF form, this one GNF form, this one GNF form, this one GNF form, but the first production is not in GNF form. Okay. So this grammar is not in GNF. Since the grammar is not in GNF, so we'll use the first formula or first rules for the conversion. See how to convert the first del Q0 epsilon. Z0. This is Q1. S, because here S is the starting symbol. So S, Z0. Next, del Q1 epsilon. Here variable. Here variable is, there are three variables, S, A, B. So Q1 epsilon S is nothing but Q1 A, A, B. Q1 A, A, B. Third one, del Q1 epsilon A is nothing but Q1 BB, Q1 BB. The fourth one, del Q1 epsilon again A, because there are two productions here. This is nothing but Q1 A. Fifth one, del Q1 epsilon B, means the next variable is B. It is nothing but AB. Q1 AB. Sixth one, del Q1 epsilon B. This is Q1 B. Seventh one, how many variables? These are called as, all are called as push operation. These are called as push operation. So how many terminals are there? So there are two terminals, A and B. Okay. So del Q1 A. It is nothing but Q1 epsilon. Eighth one, del of Q1 B. B is nothing but Q1 epsilon. So these are called as pop operation. Okay. The next one, pop the initial stack element del Q1 epsilon Z0. It is nothing but Q1 epsilon. So these are called as the pushed on automata. These are called as the pushed on automata. Okay, so one note point here. One note point. While converting from, while converting from context free grammar to pushed on automata, the pushdown automata is nothing, it is called as NPDA. NPDA means non-deterministic pushdown automata. The given means the conversion pushdown automata is called as NPDA. Okay, means this pushdown automata is nothing but it is called as NPDA. Okay, this is very very important note. While converting from context-free grammar to pushdown automata, the generated pushdown automata is nothing but it is called as non-deterministic pushdown automata. Mean what is the difference between non-deterministic and deterministic? Deterministic means for one input only one output is there, but for in case of non-deterministic pushdown automata, for one input there may be one output, there may be two output, there may be three output, like this. Three outputs means maybe for means for one input means, for example, like maybe one push operation, maybe one pop operations, like this, or there may be multiple push operations. Okay, so there may be two outputs. Okay, for example, see here this is one input, these are the all inputs are set, but there are two outputs here. There are two outputs here in the fifth and sixth case. Here there is the input is same, but there are two outputs, means for one input there are two outputs are there. So this is the, in this class we mainly discussed about the conversion from context-free grammar to pushdown automata. But if the grammar is not in GNA form, means Griebeck normal form, in the next class we'll discuss about the means if the context-free grammar is in GNA form, how to convert the means the context-free grammar or the GNF grammar to pushdown automata. Okay, thanks for watching.